Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Friends, today we are going to learn one of the component of the ratio analysis, that is the accounts receivable turnover ratio, which every entrepreneur is always concerned about, that how the turnover of account receivable is happening, what is the speed, what is the time frame. So that's what they are always looking for. Let's understand the formula. The receivables turnover ratio formula is something like this. The net credit sales, absolutely, you are analyzing that, right? Divide by the average accounts receivable. So from the net credit sales, what is the average account receivable that is standing? So let's understand what exactly are we talking about here. Now, account receivable turnover is basically another name of the turnover ratio. Now, in this ratio, we will consider the credit sales and the accounts receivable. That's what we just saw. Now, as you know, when a firm sells its goods on credit basis, it takes a decent time to get paid. So the amount that the firm would receive due to the credit sales in near future is called accounts receivable, right? Now, this ratio is a measure that computes the proportion of how much the net credit sales a firm has and how much average account receivable firm is dealing with. Now, let's have a look at the formula. The receivables turnover ratio, RTO, is equal to your net credit sales divided by your average accounts receivable, right? So let's understand with the help of an example so that you may have a clear idea what we are trying to compute. Let's say there's a company called Gigs Inc. and they have the following data, like net credit sales. The net credit sales data, let's say, is $5 lakh. They have some accounts receivable data as $40,000. And they have, this is basically the opening data. And we have account receivable closing, CLG. So that data is 60,000. Now find out the account receivable formula over here. Now, in this above example, we'll have all the information available. First, we will find out the average account receivable. So the average account receivable is going to be your opening. So I'll put this in a bracket. We'll have the opening plus we'll add the closing and then we'll divide by 2, which will give us $50,000. So by using the formula of account receivable turnover, we'll get something like this. The AR turnover ratio is equal to your net credit sales, right, divided by the average account receivables. So let's try and put the numbers. Net credit sales is your 5 lakh divided by 50,000, which will give us 10 times. So if we compare the ratio with other company under the similar industry, we'll be able to interpret whether this number is efficient or not. So this is your ARTO, that is your account receivable turnover ratio. Now let's try and understand a real life example. This was just a crude example where you can exactly understand how the formula operates. But how about we take a real life example of a company, Colgate. Let's calculate the account receivable turnover of all Colgate, and you know, we'll be having the assumption that all the sales will be on credit basis. Okay, for example, we'll take the average receivables of 2014 and 2015 data. From this particular case, the receivables turnover ratio, just check out the picture, the sales divided by the average receivables data. Okay, and over here, as shown in the image, we took the average receivables of 2014 and 2015. This is the cash and cash equivalents, and for the sales data, right? So we'll be having a couple of things on over here. On an average, the Colgate's account receivable turnover ratio has been around 10x, and the higher receivable turnover ratio implies that the higher frequency of converting the receivables into cash, which is a good thing. It's absolutely a good thing, because if you are able to convert your receivables into cash quickly, that means you have a high liquidity, and that's good for the company. That's good for the pocket of the company, right? Now, this is the receivable turnover data of Colgate. As you can see, from December 8, it has just moved up 9.62, 10.19x. Then it has moved down to 10.22, but again it has taken a rise, and it's rising. So that's a good thing. Now we note that, you know, the PNG receivables turnover ratio is slightly higher than Colgate, okay? And you know, this is basically, you know, comparison of the receivable turnover of Colgate versus the PNG data. And Unilever's receivable turnover ratio is close enough to with the Colgate numbers, right? So now let's get back to our explanation on the account receivable turnover formula. Now in the above ratio, we have two components. The first component is the net credit sales. And we need to keep in mind that here we cannot take the total net credit sales. We need to separate the cash sales and the credit sales, and that we need to deduct any sales return. Remember this thing very sure, that you know, you need to deduct any sales return related to the credit sales from the credit sales. So your sales is going to be your credit sales minus any sales return. Then you will get a right answer. The second component is the average. This is your first component. Okay, your average accounts receivable, right? Average accounts receivable. So to find out the average account receivable, we need to consider two elements. Again, the opening account receivable and the closing, to find out the average of the two. Now, what is the use? What is exactly the significance, the use of the account receivable formula? See, account receivable turnover is basically an efficiency ratio, and it is used to see how many times the account receivable have been seen collected during the fiscal year, right? Now, the third thing, the higher the account receivable turnover ratio is healthy, as we have already discussed. Okay, that's a healthy for company, and it denotes that the time interval between the credit sales and the receipt of the cash, okay, is lower, and that means that the firm is quite efficient in collecting the account receivable. On the other hand, a lower accounts receivable turnover ratio is not good or enough for the company. It indicates that the time interval between the credit sales and the receipt of the money is higher, and as a result, there is always a risk of not receiving the money. That's called the bad debts, right? And when an investor looks at the account receivable turnover, he or she needs to know how efficient the firm is in collecting the due amount. If there is any risk in delaying or not receiving the payment, it may directly affect the cash from the company. Now, this is your account receivable turnover calculator. If you put numbers over here, let's say your net credit sales is 1 million. Okay, and your average accounts receivable, which are standing in your balance sheet, is 5 lakh, right? So it's going to be half. So you are saying that, you know, my net credit sales are 1 million, but the amount outstanding that I have to recover from the debtors is only $5 lakh. So what's going to be your receivable turnover ratio? 2 times, right? So that's a bad number. You can say, no, you are only able to convert your net credit sales only 2 times into cash. Now, as this number is going to increase, let's say we are going to make it 6 lakh, your data will go down. That means your receivable turnover ratio will go down. So what interpretation we can make? As the account receivable goes down, keeping the net credit sales as same, your receivable turnover goes down, and that means it's not good. But as this amount decreases, it will automatically increase. And if we put $1 lakh over here, we'll get 10x as the number. So put down your own numbers and try and make an interpretation of the same. Thank you everyone for joining.